Hello again. My name's Chris and today I'm going to show you how I repaired my N64 controller's analog stick. This video will consist of several parts. First, I'll briefly present a fixed analog stick. Then I'll discuss the common point of failure of used analog sticks. I'll show you how to disassemble the controller, and we'll take a closer look at the analog stick module. I'll show you my solution, and then we'll reassemble the controller. Finally, a side-by-side comparison will show a fixed analog stick next to a loose one. Let's get started. To begin the video, I just want to show you my already fixed Nintendo 64 analog stick. And as you can see, this controller is gray. I know later in the Nintendo 64 life cycle, they introduced all sorts of crazy colors for the controllers. So I'm guessing this is one of the earlier ones, being a gray controller. So you would expect the stick to be the most used up of any of the colors, I guess. But you can see it's nice and tight. And no matter which direction I pull it, I instantly feel resistance, and it's not loose at all, especially up, because most of the time you're playing with some character and you're moving them forward, so you're constantly pushing up. And that's where most of the controllers are loose. And this stick, after I fixed it, is just nice and tight in every single direction. From this angle, you can see that if I rotate the stick, it doesn't touch the analog stick doesn't touch the dark gray part, so it's held up nice and high. A lot of the analog sticks, they'll sort of fall down, and when you pull them to the side, like left, right, up and down, you can sort of feel them rising up. And this stick is just, I mean, it's not loose in the vertical direction, and if I push it forward or back or left or right, I don't feel it pulling up. It's always at the same height, and when I push it forward and apply some pressure down, it's not touching the dark gray part, and it's just good as new. So I'm hoping that I'll show you how to get any N64 analog stick back into this condition. Here I've got another controller. This is a used one, and I'm gonna get a close-up on the stick so I can show you that it's in pretty bad condition. When I move it around, and I'm just moving it ever so slightly, it's loose in pretty much 50% of the area of the analog stick, and I really have to pull it really far left. Like right now, I'm starting to feel some resistance, and really far right, you can see it's more than halfway pushed to the right. In the forward direction, it's even worse. It's almost 3/4 of the way in before I start to feel any resistance at all. And then in the back direction, it's actually pretty good, because most of the time you're not moving your character backwards or something, so that's the least used direction, I guess. So if this is the center, then I guess 1/4 of the way in, I can feel resistance in the analog stick. But overall, it's in pretty bad shape. So why does it get like this, I guess, is the question people are asking. And you would think, looking at the stick, looking at that ball there in the center, that you can see that it's being held on each side by like a little nub. And you would expect that center ball of the stick to be held by those nubs in place. That's actually not how it works. And Nintendo really dropped the ball, pardon the pun, but they really dropped the ball on this design, because that ball doesn't do anything. And in fact, the more you use the stick, the more the analog stick, along with the ball, drops in. It should be at this height, and you can see that it's not. When I let it go, it falls down and you can see like a gap, which shouldn't be there. Inside the analog stick module is a sort of plastic bowl that's holding the analog stick up. And just from sheer use, just from holding it in different directions, moving it around, the plastic on both the end of the analog stick, as well as the plastic bowl that's holding it up, just simply wears away. And that's why in certain directions you'll have it be more loose, because in those areas of the plastic bowl, for example, the forward direction is the most used, but the end of the analog stick will be somewhere below here. So it's in line with the analog stick. So if I'm holding it forward, then this area right under here of the plastic bowl will be most used. And oppositely, the back direction is usually the least used, and in this controller it's actually pretty good. So you would expect the area of the bowl under here to be the least worn away. And I was talking about the good stick. I was saying that it's always at the same height. And this is what I'm talking about, that the used sticks will just drop in. And for example, when I pull back, so you can see the ball sort of rise up, and you can feel the whole stick sort of rise up when you put tension on it. And it shouldn't be like that. It should always be at the same height and always rotate about the center ball. So my solution aims to fix that problem by raising the stick up. And now disassembly of the controller. So to get at the analog stick module, we just simply have to take the controller apart. And it's not a complicated design at all. The shell just consists of two pieces, the top piece and this bottom piece, which is held in by just some simple Phillips screws. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, I guess I would call them medium-sized Phillips screws. And then inside here, in the expansion area, two smaller screws. And I just have like a really cheap screwdriver, and I use it because it fits perfectly into these holes. So I'm just going to start by unscrewing these seven big screws, and then I'll tackle the two smaller ones. Right. So those are loose, and now keep the top part of the shell with the analog stick facing down and simply lift up gently on the bottom shell. And that's it. And just set it aside. And now we have access to the analog stick module. And first, to get the module unscrewed, we have to unscrew these three screws, 1, 2, and 3. Do not unscrew this black screw because it keeps the two parts of the analog stick module together. We'll be unscrewing that later, but to get the module out from the controller, we have to unscrew the three light-colored screws. And also, the Z button should be popped out like that. And this connector has to be disconnected. So just pry that out. Comes out really easily. And now we're going to unscrew these three light-colored screws to get to the analog stick module. The second one and the last one. And it's already coming loose. All right, so we can set that aside. Get these three screws somewhere. Okay, and that's it. We have gotten to the analog stick module, and we'll be taking that apart shortly. Okay, so let's take a closer look at the analog stick module now. This is the whole module, and when I move the analog stick, you can see that it's still really loose, just like it was before, nothing changed. We're going to take this apart and see exactly what's causing it to be this loose, and you'll see why it's loose in the up direction, not so much in the down direction, left and right, about in the middle, and so forth. So you can see that it's made from two pieces, this light gray bottom piece and the dark gray top piece. And sort of the best way to get this thing open is to pinch with your fingers the two pieces together like this, unscrewing the black screw. And the black screw is keeping the two plastic pieces together, but inside there's a spring pushing them apart. So you want to be holding them together with your fingers so the spring doesn't push the two pieces apart sort of by itself and make a mess of the insides. And you'll see what I mean in a second. So we got the black screw out, and you can see that it's coming apart. That's because the spring is inside. Now we're going to turn it around, holding it together, and there are these two like clips, and you want to gently, that's one clip, you want to gently sort of release the clips. Okay, now they're both released, and you want to keep the whole thing level, nice and level, and let it come up. Okay, whoa, what's that? Well, that gunk in there, that powder, is ground up plastic from the analog stick, the end of the analog stick, which is here, and the plastic bowl, that's this white thing, keeping the analog stick held up. And over years of use, you just get a bunch of gunk in there. So the first thing I recommend you do is take a brush or like just blow the stuff out, but to just clean up the whole inside of the analog stick module. So this part, and you can see that this top part is sort of self-contained. You have a spring which is pushing against this white ring, and on the white ring there's like a black sort of, I don't know what you would call, like a bearing or something, I'm not really sure, and this is for the left and right movement. So when you rotate the stick left or right, you'll be pushing against this, I'm going to call it a bearing, this black thing, and then it rotates this gear, sort of like gear arc, and then it rotates some like a little wheel in the analog stick mechanism. So here you can see, or maybe not, yeah, there you can see the wheel, and it rotates that, and that's the left and right movement, and the same goes for top down movement, except the top down movement bearing is loose in the bowl, and you can just take it out like that. So that's the big bearing for the top down movement. Now the bowl is empty except for all the gunk, and then the top bit is self-contained, and to release the white ring and this bearing, you want to hold the analog stick with your fingers, and you can see you can twist it a little bit. So either twist with your fingers or keep the analog stick steady and then twist the bearing with your fingers, and if you line them up just right, this will come out, and now you've taken apart the whole thing. So there's the white ring, the spring, the bearing for the left-right movement. Now you've got the analog stick. If you rotate that back, you can see it will just come right out of the top part of the module, and it's all completely disassembled now. So what I would recommend at this stage is to just clean all this stuff, and then we'll talk about fixing the analog stick. So what was causing the looseness of the joystick? Well, primarily it's caused by wearing away of this white ball by the analog stick, which causes the stick to just drop down. So instead of being raised up a little, and then this little ball of the analog stick will be right up top, right against the right against these nubs. So instead of being right here in the middle, it'll drop down. See, and then it wiggles. You can see the gap. It wiggles inside, and that's the primary source of looseness. The second cause of looseness is that when you move the joystick up and then left or right, what you're actually doing is you're wearing away the insides of these black pieces. So I'll zoom in to show that. So these have been worn away pretty badly, and you can see the analog stick has really just dug deep in there, and this should all be nice and filled out, but it's worn away. And when the analog stick is inside like that, the idea is that when you push, see, it should immediately push against this black piece, turning the gear, which then tells the controller, oh, you move the analog stick. What really happens when it's worn away is that it'll be loose, and you can push it up or down several millimeters, which corresponds to like 20, 30, 40, maybe even 50 degrees before it registers. So you can, you know, when the analog stick's really loose, you can turn it like this far before it registers, when normally it should be just really tight. So the second you turn it, turn the stick, this black piece turns with it. So how do we fix it? Well, I saw one method on YouTube that recommended drilling a hole in this white plastic bowl, and then filling it with like epoxy resin, and the hole was supposed to let the epoxy resin like flow in there so that it would stick better and not, you know, not fall out, and it would just be a better fit. And then you could just selectively wear away the epoxy resin to rebuild the original shape of this plastic piece, which would then hold the joystick up at the correct height, which would eliminate the first sort of cause of looseness. I didn't try that. I sort of find it a little unwieldy because you have to recreate the original shape of the piece, and I'm not sure what that is, so it's sort of, you have to do it on a case-by-case basis. I found another video which recommended tying a string around the analog stick, tying a string right above the ball here. And the idea is that when you reassemble the stick, see, it's like in this position. So when, if I can show this, if you had a string tied around here, it would increase the tightness of the analog stick against this black piece, so that the analog stick will be more raised up because now it's loose. So, you know, this is what's allowing the analog stick to drop. And if there was something in there to hold it up, well, it would stay up. So I tried the string method, but I found that it's squishy, it fails after a certain time. So I thought, well, I could put something harder in there, but what kind of shape am I going to put in here that would allow for this type of movement and keep the analog stick held up? And I figured, well, it would have to be some sort of spherical piece of plastic, and how am I gonna do that without having like a 3D plastic printer? Well, I figured out that if I wore away, let me show this. If I wore away these top edges of the black piece, because right now there's it's like a V shape going up, but if I wore them away so that looking sort of like across the piece, if I just flattened these edges, I could put something that was U-shaped in there, or like cylindrical, in other words. Well, and then I thought, what's cylindrical? Well, I took the closest thing that was cylindrical that was next to me, and it was an old pen. And I still have the barrel of the pen that I used, and you can see that it is just about the right outside diameter, and you can see that there's just a tiny little gap there, which will go away if, like I said, you wore away those top edges. And then the inside diameter is almost exactly right for the ball of the analog stick. So, in other words, I'm going to wear away the edges of this black piece, and then cut the barrel of the pen into some sort of U shape, and then fit the ball of the analog stick in there so that it will always be held up by the black piece. And that's what I've done on the fixed analog stick, and I'm going to show you that right now. So this is what it looks like. And you can see that this is the position that the analog stick is in. So it's not loose at all. I'm pulling it up and down, and it's not dropping. And it's free to rotate. There's no friction whatsoever. And the way I did it is just like I said before, just cut a little piece, and there's like a notch in there. So the analog stick can just fit in there. Now, this hole has to be the exact diameter of the analog stick. And I'm going to measure that right now with a caliper. Three and a half millimeters. Yeah. So take a 3.5 millimeter drill. I'm not sure what that is in inches. And cut a piece of, where is it? Right here. And cut a piece of plastic from like a pen barrel or something, or maybe like a thin piece of thin run of pipe or something. Cut it just like that, and then cut a little notch in the side so you can slip the analog stick in, and then it won't fall out. And here you'll notice there's also some like I filed it around the edge here, so that it would fit a little bit better with the ball. So it's not like a perfect fit just right out of the box. I also had to file a little bit on the inside so that, see, so it sort of complements the sphere shape of the ball. And then when you put the when you put the black piece on there, And this was sort of, I also did it on a case-by-case basis. But when you file everything just perfectly, there's no friction. It's held up perfectly by this black piece. So this fixes the first problem of the analog stick, that is that it falls down. So now the analog stick will never fall down. However, the second problem is, like I was saying, the worn away like bearings or these black pieces. This one is in pretty good shape. It's almost not worn away at all. The ones in the unfixed analog stick, here they are, they're worn away pretty badly. So a way to fix that would be, again, to use like epoxy resin to build up the plastic here, or super glue or something, or I guess another solution would be to widen these slots and then put something around the analog stick so that it'll be thicker and then fit in the slots nice and tightly. But the idea is that you want to raise the analog stick up like that. Oh, this is the one. You want to raise the analog stick up using the first black piece, and then you want to make sure that the insides of the black pieces are nice and tight so that when you move the analog stick, they immediately turn with the analog stick, and then you'll have nice resistance of the stick, no looseness, and the stick will be good as new. Now I'm going to show you how I made that little plastic support piece to hold up the analog stick. And I was saying before that I just used the barrel of a pen, but you could conceivably use any sort of plastic, like PVC type pipe. The outside diameter is 10 millimeters and the inside diameter is 7 millimeters. The inside diameter is more important because it's going to hold the ball of the analog stick tightly, and you could always just wear away the outside to match the black piece. Okay, so what I did, I took the pen, I put it in a vise to hold it nice and tight, and then using a nice fine saw blade, and this is just a regular coping saw, what I did is I cut it into about 6 or 7 millimeter length pieces. Here I actually have the end of a previous pen, and this is about 2 lengths, so this is about 12 or 14 millimeters. But imagine that this was about half the length, so about like that, 6 or 7 millimeters. I would then take a box cutting knife and cut it down, and then I would have 2 U shapes. So the result of that would be a piece like this. And this is what I consider to be sort of raw material for the support piece. The next step would then be to take a 3.5 millimeter drill bit, and I'm holding this in my hand, but of course this would have to be done using a drill or like a machine to drill the hole right in there, which would then hold the analog stick. And then I take a slightly larger drill. This is a 5 millimeter, but I also used 6 millimeter. And this time, holding it with my hand, after I had the hole drilled, I would then manually sort of turn the drill to wear away the outside edge, or the inside edge rather, of the hole to make it sort of more spherical to hold the ball of the analog stick better. Also, this piece, as it is, it's slightly too large, so it's also necessary to clip away a little bit of this edge and a little bit of this edge, and also using some sandpaper right here, I would sand away a little bit of this edge, and a little bit of this edge, and also the corners. So I would be left with something that looks just about like this. This is a finished piece, and the only thing that you would then have to do is just on one side here, using a box cutter, cut about, I guess, a millimeter or 2 millimeter length hole, so that then you can slip the analog stick into that hole. And then these are the black support pieces, and remember that the smaller one is the left-right movement, and it's the one that's going to be holding up the analog stick along with the white piece. And as I was saying before, it's necessary to file down these edges. So just using a rounded file, I just flatten these edges so they're no longer like pointing up in a V-shape, but are just flat. And then if the insides of these black pieces are worn away, it's necessary to build them up with something. I used two glues, a two-part epoxy glue and then super glue. On this smaller piece, the left-right movement piece, I just used super glue because it dries really quick and really hard, and then I can file it. On this larger piece, there was a lot more plastic missing, so what I did is I used a two-part epoxy glue to sort of roughly, coarsely fill in the missing plastic, and then I topped it off with super glue once again because it dries really fast and I can file it down. And the two-part epoxy, once it dried, which took about a whole day, but I guess the glue that I used was pretty low quality, so I'm sure that there are other ones that dry much faster. But mine, after it dried, was not quite as hard as I wanted it to be. It was a little rubbery, so I topped it off with super glue. But you could, I guess, find a better type of glue. I think there's like a liquid metal type of glue that, you know, dries really fast and is also really hard. So the second super glue would be unnecessary in that case. And the idea is that you want the this end piece of the joystick to just barely be able to slide in. So it's just a little bit tight. And if it's a little bit tight here, like that, then it's going to be perfect inside the analog stick. And that goes both for this larger piece, the bottom piece for the up-down movement, as well as the smaller piece for the left-right movement. You just want it to barely be able to slide in, because the idea is that when you move the analog stick, you want there to be no leeway in here. Now that we've fixed and modified the two black pieces and fashioned ourselves a support piece, we're ready to put back together the analog stick and have it be working nice and tight. So the first step is to start with this base piece, the bottom piece with the white ball, and we want to first insert the black piece for the up-down movement. That's the first thing, and then we're going to set that aside. And now we want to take the top piece, but upside down, and first, through it, we take the analog stick and set it down like that. Now we put on the white support piece. You can't put the support piece on first because otherwise it wouldn't go through. So that's the reason that we have to put the joystick in through first. And then now the spring with the white ring like that. And then turn the black piece so that it's at a 90 degree angle to the original position. So for example, like that. This is the original position with the gear like that. So we want to turn it like that, 90 degrees, and then holding the whole thing together. We want to slide the joystick in like that, but you have to orient the support piece underneath so that it fits like that. So now everything's together. I rotate using my fingers the joystick like that underneath, and now the whole thing can be turned like that. All right, so now we have the joystick in the original position. The holes are on the left and right side. Those align with the nubs of this top part. The white support piece is underneath in the correct orientation. This end piece of the joystick is holding the black piece against the spring. So this is sort of assembled. Now we bring the two halves together and put it down just like that. And you want to make sure, looking from the side, that this black piece for the up-down movement is about level, so that when you put this in straight down, the end of the joystick will slide right in there. So just like that. And you may feel a little bit of resistance as you're putting it back together. Oops. Or you can do it like that, huh, I guess. All right, so just like that. All right. And now, holding this bottom end with your fingers, flip the whole thing over, put the black thin screw into the hole, and screw it in. All right, that's screwed in. So this is the analog stick after it's been fixed. So just to show you guys, compared to the analog stick in totally unfixed condition and then semi-fixed condition, this is with loose black pieces, so unaltered black pieces, but with the support piece holding the joystick up. So here we see that the joystick, first of all, falls down. It's totally loose, so just it's horrible. I guess the only direction that sort of works halfway decent is back. Here we have the semi-fixed joystick. It's already a lot better, but still pretty loose. It doesn't fall down, but it's not great. And then here's the fixed one. Just you can see there is almost no looseness at all. It is really tight. Take it right, left, down, up. It's just nice and solid any way you take it. So that's it. Now, lastly, we have to put the whole thing back together. So this is the two shells of the N64 controller. We want to flip the whole thing over and take the bottom off. Put the analog stick module back into the center spot here, and we just want to take the three light screws, and using a Phillips screwdriver, screw those back in. The connector, there's only one for the analog stick, slide that back in. It should click, it's in. And now the Z button. We want to just put that back into place, and that's it. So now we put the bottom half of the shell back on, like that. And now just screw back in these seven screws, and then the two small thin ones. I'm not going to do that on camera, but that's the idea. So that is the reassembled controller with the fixed analog stick. I hope you enjoyed my video. Thanks for watching.